What a piece of junk.
Here we have one of the rear landing gears. Now their ship has five landing gears. Two of these large ones and three single legs landing gears. Three guesses what I'm going to do with these. I'm going to modify them. The first thing I'm going to do, and I tried using sanding this edge off, and that took a long time and it didn't really result anything. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to use a knife like this. Where are we? I'm looking upside down at the camera now. A knife like this, and what are the landing gears, and I'm going to cut along the line over here. I'm going to cut off this side, not all the way, but I'm going to leave about 5 millimeters on here and 5 millimeters over here, and the same over here. I'm going to do it on all four sides. So this might also take a while, but at least it's a lot cleaner than using a sanding. Oh, I'm not in picture. Where am I? Once again, I have to look at the camera. Visor upside down now. So I'm going to cut this. I'm using an old cloth on my lap to prevent me cutting in my legs, but I probably will. Why not cut on the desk where you have a cutting table? Because I'm stupid. So every comment you may have concerning me building the Falcon or doing anything else or really fudging it up, just remember I am being stupid. Talk about being stupid, I had to change a few things concerning the weathering on the side of the Falcon I did last week. I watched the end result and I didn't really like it. So what I did, I used a dry brush and some of the hull color, and I just added a number of highlights to the side panel of the Falcon. Looks a lot better. So I'm gonna make these cuts now, and we'll be back as soon as all four of them have been cut off. All the side frames have now been cut off, and I'm gonna install new ones. Looks a bit counterproductive. I'm gonna put a bit of glue on the section which I just cut off. Super glue. And I have made four strips of 5 centimeters by, did I do it wrong? I had it folded right and I glued it on wrong. So it needs to be glued in like this. Strange, because I just made one earlier, and one would suggest that if I made already one before that, that I would know how to do it. Okay, so like this, and you may already guess what I am doing with this. I'm using some additional super glue to make sure it stays in place. And what I also did, I cut off these pins over here. These are not really necessary with the modifications that I'm going to do with it. So I cut them off. And now I have to glue in all four of these little strips I made. And then it's off to step three. With these flaps now on, it's time to glue in what I've made earlier, which is actually I used some photographs of other people who made these, and I try to recreate as much as I could the actual landing gear doors. The problem is there's not much what's to go on. You don't see many photographs of the actual doors, the landing gears. So I'm trying the best as I can, and I just glue in these panels. And as soon as they're dry, I'm going to probably glue in some additional greebles, not as much greebles, but more additional panels, so they look a bit more like the doors when they are closed. Oh, I need to cut this into size apparently. Okay, hold on. Let me cut this a bit shorter. Because if you look at the doors which Deagostini has supplied with this kit, these are all the closed doors, of course. Because now they look like this, and that doesn't look that good. But if you, hold up, take one of these panels, you can see all different kinds of additional panels on top of them. These are, as is supposed to be, the doors, the closed doors like these. You don't see this these angles, by the way, but they are supposed to be there. So what I need to do is mimic these panels onto these over here by just gluing on separate pieces of styrene sheet, painting them, and then also a bit weathering so they resemble these panels, and then I can use magnets which I have glued over here, two magnets, and same magnets in the holes where the landing gear is supposed to go in, and then that will be sufficient to have these landing gears stuck on. As you can see, this is a one that we made earlier. I have already painted it, but they still require some additional panels. Okay, now all this is in place. The same goes for the rear landing gear, however. Apparently it has a fold. So it's on one side it's straight, on the other it's supposed to be folded in. So I had to first make this fold by making two pieces of styrene, glue them together, and have a small strip of styrene in the center to keep them into a particular angle. And these also have the magnets already glued in, and all I need to do is have this glue dry, and hopefully this glue, which has been supplied by the company who sold me the magnets, hold on, this stuff, which is Max Repair glue, apparently this is better than the cyanacrylate glue. It is a bit thicker, so it doesn't drip everywhere. It's supposed to be the best bond for these magnets, so hopefully they are right. This is actually the glue I'm going to use to glue on the magnets inside the holes where the caverns where these landing gear are supposed to go in. As you can see, I have opened up these slots because otherwise they won't fit. But with all the greebles later in place, you're not going to see them anyway. As I said, I've added some panels, random pieces of styrene sheet, rectangles or squares, and used the pre-shading technique, like I did on the Falcon hull, to accentuate these. Now, the entire idea of this operation is that whenever you want to insert the landing gear onto the Falcon, the doors are now included. And whenever you want to remove the landing gear from the Falcon and put in the by Deagostini included doors which are shut off the landing gear, then these doors will get off too. So this is one complete set of landing gear plus doors which you could insert or remove from the Falcon whenever you choose. It's weird that they didn't include these doors in the Deagostini kit. Probably because the Deagostini kit, of course, is a replica of the filming model, and as far as I know, the filming model probably didn't have these doors. They were probably later added in by animation, although I can't be certain. At least, as I said earlier, I'm not trying to 100% emulate the filming model. I'm just trying to create a exciting model of a spaceship, like I would do any other model kit, and that will include, of course, the doors of the landing gear. Now it's a very, very light coat of the base color. I am, of course, going to weather the landing gear later on, but there's another part coming in hopefully this weekend, which I have to obtain, which will include the weathering and detailing of this landing gear. And as I said earlier, I'll try to see if I can actually create that center column on the double landing gear sets like these. I have added green onto this landing gear set, and you might probably realize why I did that, because I have also added the same green onto the door of the landing gear. Oh, I can see there's a red plank over here, so I have to recreate that red. Anyway, that was not what I was going to say. In the form of an arrow, these doors are the same. That is to say, this landing gear is going into the position where I've also added the green on the Falcon, and this door is also in the same position, so I do not need to wonder which door goes where or which landing gear goes where. The green goes in green, and the same goes for the other landing gear doors, which are red, orange, yellow and blue. There's something else I wanted to talk about. Now that this landing gear is almost finished, apart from some weathering here and there, I believe that this is a bit bare. So I was wondering, I have here some spare tracks from I believe a Tiger 1 tank. Yes, a Tiger 1 tank. You're supposed to glue these in together and create a track for the Tiger tank, or at least this is a spare track. But I was thinking, what if I took off these tracks sections, cut off a section of that track, and then only leave this behind? And what if I glue these exactly like this? Now it looks a bit like a hinge. At least I think it does, a bit looking like a hinge. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to add hinges to the doors. I'm probably going to cut off the elongated fins over here. And that will look like hinges for these doors, and probably will make the doors look a lot better. So that's what I'm going to do now. I'm going to cut off 20 of these parts. 4 for each landing gear, 4 times 5 of course means 20, and gluing them in. There's a nice little music store in the neighboring town of Spijkenisse. It's called Frederick's Music Store. I've been there last night, and I needed some guitar strings for a specific project. And talked with the owner and said, well, I'm not going to use it for a guitar, I'm going to use it for model building. He said, well, it doesn't surprise me, because I've got people over here which ask for music strings or guitar strings for different kinds of projects. So I was looking for the correct size, and then he found me two of these envelopes, and he said, here, take them for free, because I'm not going to sell these anyway. So that's very nice. So I got two bags of guitar strings, and like this, I already cut this. Now, why do I need guitar strings for the Millennium Falcon? It's for the landing gear. Yes, there is something going on with the landing gear which involves guitar strings. Now, this is not my idea. This is something I've learned from one of the numerous Facebook Build the Millennium Falcon groups, which I've been frequently visiting, and they come up with all kinds of nice tips, suggestions and ideas which I've been borrowing or stealing here and there. So this is something I borrowed from them too. What do we need to do with these guitar strings? First of all, we need a hand drill. We're going to drill several holes in the back of the landing gear. There are a few pictures online which show you how and where you can actually drill these holes. However, it's also nice to actually wing it a little bit So I'll drill a hole over here in the back. Oh, sorry, can you see? I'll drill a hole over here in the back. I'm using a drill which has almost the same diameter as these guitar string. So this is one hole. And then I'm going to drill another hole. Let's see where I'm going to do it. I'm going to drill it over here. Which is... Well, it doesn't really make that lot of a difference where you drill the hole. Because there are not many, as I said, not many pictures available of the exact position of where these holes are supposed to be. Just in the general location. What I need to do, of course, is be sure that I don't drill in the magnets. I keep going out of picture. Frame, sorry. Let me move the camera a bit, because I'm keep getting out of the frame. That's better. So, as I said, I have to be careful not to drill where the magnets are. So, now that I drilled our two holes, I'm going to take my piece of guitar string. So, take three. Yes, that goes a lot smoother. Okay, it's inside the hole. Now, let's make a twist, and let's turn it from the inside now through the other hole. Let me make sure that I keep in camera while I am trying to fit through the hole. Okay, that's in. Now I'm going to take this pair of... What are these? Pliers or tweezers? I'm never sure. Oh, drop me a line in the comments, will you? I'm never sure if these are tweezers or pliers. I believe it's pliers. And I'll make a straight edge, 45 degrees edge. Pull it up down. And now I'm going to do the same on over here. So I'm going to pull this string in as far as I can. Make the cut around here. I need a new cutting device. Okay, and make another of these twists. 90 degrees, like so. Pull it back down, so it goes like this. And then glue these ends in later. And what I have created is, I simulated these cables, which are in fact on the legs of the Falcon. I have one made earlier this morning with several cables in. These of course need to be painted, and then the entire thing needs to be wetted, but that is what I'm going to do. So I'm going to add a few more cables to this, and of course some cables to the front landing gear. I've got, as I said, two of these guitar strings of length. I'm not sure how long these are. It says here 0.54. This is probably the diameter in inches, and this might be the length, maybe 1.3 foot. I'm not sure. It's made in the USA, so it's very unlikely these are centimeters or millimeters. Anyway, I'm going to continue cutting these strings, putting them in, and then when I'm going to start weathering and painting them, we will return to the video. I've added this center column, as you can see, to the design of the undercarriage. Supposedly there are also, hold on, there's also supposed to be some sort of a extension box over here, which is connected to this one through a pipe like over there. That is going to be a bit difficult to do. I can't reach that anymore, and even if I could, I have to, in that case, I would have to remove the entire landing gear from the landing gear console. I did screw it in, but I also did glue it in, so I can't remove it anymore. There are separate pieces you can buy through Shapeways, but I'm not going to do that. Maybe I'll do later. I do also know there is actually a complete landing gear with boxes, with all the pipes, hoodocks, and the doors available through Shapeways for about 90 euros. I might do that later, because these of course will not be glued in the Falcon, these will be used with magnets. But for the time being, I will use this method. Now, how did I do this? And I'm going to do it for this one too, by the way. How did I do this? First of all, I used a cotton swab, cut off the both ends, and simply glued it between these two logs over here, these two boxes over here. First I thought maybe I could drill a hole and push it in, but I can't get in straight because of all the cables, so I just had to jam it between those two pieces and glue it in. Now, you do see some glue residue over here, but this is going to be heavily weathered and used with some powder to grime it up, so you're probably not going to see it. These boxes, which I talked about earlier, I'm not going to put them in. And the way I did this is, I'm going to do it over here. Here we have the other landing gear with the tube in between. So I cut two of these pieces from styrene, and they're almost identical. I'm going to glue one on the back. I'm going to do that right now. So I'm going to add some super glue, because this styrene gluing to the rod I have placed over here is not going to work with styrene glue. So I use some super glue, use a tweezer, and try to maneuver it into place, and hopefully that the super glue will grasp on. It did in the first try. This center box is supposedly connected to the plate, but I'm not going to do that either because there's a light up there and I can't connect a rod over there. Oh, sorry, out of frame. So now I'm waiting until this glue is dry, and then I'm going to cut off small strips of styrene and glue them over here, one over here, one over there, one over here, and one over there, and maybe, as you can see it over there, and maybe I'll glue one over here, but first let this dry, and then probably use some sprue goo to mask off any irregularities which we have over here. As you can see, it's not really matching over here. I could maybe try to maneuver this piece a bit better, because the glue is not fully dry yet. Oh, let's be careful, I'm not gonna remove this thing. Oh dear, it's a little bit better now. Anyway, but also, as I said, it's gonna be heavily wetted, and I'm probably going to try, there are supposed to be some cross beams coming from over here to here, like so. I'm not going to do that either, I believe. It's or I might be looking at my box of spare parts. Maybe I will, but I'm not sure. Considering the fact that this landing gear is going to be housed underneath the Falcon, the only way you can actually spot these irregularities is by looking underneath the Falcon. So we're not going to do that. We're not going to mess with that. There may be some other, there's also another other thing, let me finish off. There is actually a supposed to be a connection between the back of the front leg to the toe of the rear leg. There is supposed to be another connection. I'm not sure if I'm gonna do that, but let me first glue this in, and let's see if I will be doing this. There is supposed to be a lot of rods and hinges. I don't think I'll be able to replicate that. I might be able to replicate that, but I don't think I'm going to replicate this. So let me finish off the center column first, and then let's see how far we will reach. With the back section now in and all the side panels in, all four of them, I'm going to glue on the top panel by just using the styrene glue and putting a layer of, well, a drop of glue on the sides of the side panel. using a tweezer to grab it on the over here in the bottom, because there is no glue over there and no side panel over there either yet. And now let's see if we can actually move it into position. Now, I am by no means a wizard when it comes to making styrene things. I've seen people doing things which are beyond amazing. I've seen people making picket fences out of styrene. I've seen people making things which you can't believe, like benches for railroad, mini railroad sets, just seating benches. I am most definitely not in their league. I'm just trying to model through a bit. Okay, that's in, and then let's keep this to dry, and then let's see if I can continue, if I can make a thing on the bottom. I probably won't. I'll probably use some sprue goo for that. And let's see if I can actually make a toe to heel connection. Once again, not sure if I'm going to do this, but let's see how far we get. Okay, I've done some. I had some washing now. I have some rust effects, and now I'm gonna put some layer of clear coat on it, flat clear coat, and heavily going to use these pigments which I have. I'm gonna dabble them all over, and gonna really grime it up all over the landing gear, especially the foot, of course, but also the cables, the rods, and any kind of irregularities that might occur on the self-made additions will now fade away with these this grime on top, this grime and this the powder. Normally you don't use, of course, the powder on a wet model. It's something on a dry model, but in this case I want the powder to stick on and really grime things up. I'm probably going to add some additional wash over it later, but this is also going to give it a bit less of a smooth finish, because that is not how this landing gear looks like when you look at the close at, let's say, Empire Strikes Back. It's grimed up. So I'm maybe going to use some smoke color from Tamiya in combination with some yellow to simulate grease stains. But let's first let this dry, and let's see how this will looks when it looks out looks like when it's dried up. And voila, they're in. Well, I did use some smoke, Tamiya smoke, and then use another batch of flat varnish, flat coat, but I think they turned out pretty okay. They look a lot different now than they were. So yeah, I'm reasonably okay with it. So with these five landing gears in, one could argue that it's now time to see if it will stand on its own legs. For the first time now, the Falcon is on its own legs. It has never stood on its own legs before. It has always been on its jig or on the four metal rods, but now it is, for the first time, standing on its own feet. So, here we are. I switched on the lights for the landing gear. And here she is, on her own feet, with his lights on. Now, I believe that the battery for the lights is a bit low, so we're not seeing it in its full glory, but yeah, I think I think that does it. And she isn't, as I feared, wobbly. I thought that one of the landing gears was a bit longer than the other one due to a problem while construction, but no, it's in its place and it's not wobbly at all. Well, I thought it was finished, but I had to remove the right landing gear, right in the back. There was a small problem. This landing gear, when installed, is going to activate a switch on the bottom of the Falcon, which will light up the landing lights near the docking ports. I've shown you this switch several weeks, maybe months ago. It didn't work. So what I did was, and I understood why it didn't work. It was because of the magnets, of course, that the entire construction was a bit too high up. So what I did, I glued a bit of styrene over here, and then, as I said, if I now remove the paint jar again, put her back on her feet. If I now switch on the original power supplied with the Deagostini kit and activate the test button, now, as you may see, the large lights which I've made near the docking port some months ago do function, and in combination with the lights which I've made myself, so these work. Hold, wait a minute, let's try something else, because there's something else I need to do, of course, with this Falcon before I go on working on the top section when it comes to the weathering. There's something I need to do. Okay. What's going on? What's going on? What's going on? So I removed the top hull again, and this, kids, is why you do not glue in the side panels. As the instructions say, use magnets. I removed the top panel and then discovered the problem was not with the engine or through the motor or anything else that was bothering it. It was quite simple. Once again, glue. Apparently glue was spilled some weeks or months before, and that resulted in the fact that the ramp wouldn't open. So I managed to remove the glue, sanded it smooth again, and it will now open and close. But I have kept it open now so I can... Hold on. Let me turn the camera a bit. I have left the ramp open, as you can see, so I will be able to paint the inside. I also took the liberty of using a new turntable, which is much more smoother. Of course, while it was opened, I replaced the light which was over here in the front, which failed to run again, so I had to replace the light. I didn't glue the light in very firmly because, well, let's hope it doesn't, but if it would ever fail again, that can actually then easily remove it. Now, before I'm gonna screw back the top hull, what I might do now is, or might gonna do now, is drill out these holes. As you can see, these are the blast marks on the top hull. There are several places where these are. These are large holes. There are several smaller strips where there are blast marks over here. And I believe there are some on the top near the gun. And there are a few over in the back near the engine compartment. I'm probably going to drill out these holes, or at least increase the size of these holes right now before I screw the top back on, because if I do that, then I won't risk the problem of vibrating the entire Falcon and that all the screws once again fall out, because I have that in the past, that when I start a Dremel and start to make holes or increase the size of the holes, then the vibration will actually have some of the screws fall out of the construction, which is not good. So that is where I want to leave it this week. Next week we will most likely be gluing in the new cockpit, and after that we are going to start working on the weathering on the top hull of the Falcon, and that might actually be the very last thing I'm gonna do. I hope you enjoyed this week's episode. It was a bit more interesting than the week before that. This landing gear thing. Hope to see you next week, and we might finish the Falcon next week, although there is a small caveat. There is still a piece missing, which is of course issue 100A with the missing parts. We still haven't received that yet. We are now 20, let's see, what date is it today? It's the 25th of December. I'm not quite sure if we have any mail delivery between now and January 1st, but here's hoping. Anyway, thank you for watching. If you have already subscribed to this channel, thank you very much. If you haven't, please do so accordingly. Please give this video a thumbs up, and we'll see each other next week. Goodbye!